Here's an inside look at the SpongeBob Musical produced by Belmont High School Performing Arts Company.
We have shows March 17th, 18th, and 19th. For tickets and more info, go to bhs-pac.org.
Yay!
We wanted to do something that was fun. We knew we wanted to do something that felt like it was a celebration. We wanted to do something that was going to be colorful, that was going to let us show off our new theater space and all of the cool things that the theater space can do. So this one fit the bill. It's bright. It's colorful. You know, we've got the coral reef set on stage. We've got so many props that are bright colors. We've been spray painting things and decorating things. The costumes, I think, are the same, are like bright, shiny, colorful. The music is big and bright. It's a show that creating the underwater world of an animated series is really exciting and fun.
Good morning, Patrick. Good morning, Oliver. Yep, and I'm singing the opening number.
I would say one of the things that's been so wonderful this year about all of our students in the PAC is the way that they have completely just embraced being a community, being an ensemble. They seem so happy to be working together in rehearsal every day. Like, they just bring a spirit of joy and collaboration to everything they do, while also making sure that they're working hard, that they have sort of ambitious to try and make the work really excellent on stage. And I think it's helped them learn a tremendous amount of stuff.
SpongeBob is a yellow sea sponge who lives in a pineapple under the sea, and he is a fry cook at the Krusty Krab, but he's always wanted to be the manager of the Krusty Krab. And in the musical, he has to live up to his name and try to overcome the great challenge of the end of the world.
I'm playing Patrick Starr, and Patrick is SpongeBob's best friend. They are basically inseparable. Patrick is kind of like the side, like, comic relief. And he's meant to be very stupid. He literally lives under a rock, like, that's his house. And just says a lot of, like, silly, stupid things that are meant to make the audience laugh.
And you're the reason why, let's have some fun together.
You're my best friend forever.
Forever, that's better for us. If it can't get any better, you're my best friend forever.
Sandy the squirrel. So she's a lot of things. She's a scientist. She also is very into karate. And she's overall just like a very like feisty personality, but she's very smart too.
The science is clear. I'm afraid it's true. The end's really here. There's nothing we can do. And if finally the numbers rise, our time is.
Have these custom claws that I
love. They're really fun to use, and they make me feel very crabby. He just radiates this like confidence. Like, he really just doesn't care what anyone thinks. All he cares about is money. Like, there's so many times on stage where I'm so mean to my daughter. I just completely ignore Pearl and SpongeBob. Like, everyone is expressing things to me, and I'm just constantly blind to them because I'm just so dedicated to earning money.
Good weather's best when you're in the mood to make a ton of money.
I think it took some time for me to settle into like the big booming voice of the role, because like I just kind of like the laugh was such a prominent part of my childhood, to be like I'm expected to go like on stage. Like, that was kind of like a big like scary thing, but once I kind of just was like ready to do it and I started doing it, I really settled into the part, and that's been great. So.
Get ready, Patrick. I have a plan to save our town, and I need your help. We're gonna use science to stop the volcano from erupting.
Huh? Oh, sorry. I found this great belly button scratcher, and we've been having a really nice time together.
Patrick, I need to know, are you with me?
I'm right here, hello.
No, I mean, are you with me metaphorically until we actually start with the town saving?
I don't know what metaphorically means, buddy. Yes, I'm with you.
Then welcome to the team.
Our team needs a name. How about Team Pat Bob?
I prefer Sponge Rick.
Ipso facto, I can design an explosive device. Figure 3, to drop into the mouth of the volcano. Figure 4, with a timer set to detonate the precise moment of eruption. Figure 5, unleashing a deluge of bubbles that will release the pressure and prevent the blast.
You lost me at 1.
Mr. Krabs, if she doesn't want to be manager, I know someone who'd be great for the job.
You! You're just a simple sponge, boy, and yet you don't seem to absorb very much.
I am really happy that we're getting to do the show and looking forward to having audiences come see it.